All right, well, we're gonna work on today something a little different. We are going to change the oil cooler on this 3.6 liter Jeep junk. When I was in Colorado, I noticed it was pouring oil out everywhere. Get up underneath it, you can see everything down there is wet with oil. That's because the oil cooler's leaking and it's filling the valley up, and when we would go up a steep incline, it would pour out. So I'm gonna set this up and start taking this apart. We'll try to do this with minimal hollering and screaming and beating on stuff. First thing you gotta do is get to it. Means we're going to take the majority of the Jeep off. The Mopar and their infinite wisdom buried that thing so far in there you can't find it. You got to take this off. Reach up underneath here and they got a mass airflow sensor you have to unplug. Some of this stuff might not actually have to come off, but I just take it off because I've done this a couple of times on some other Jeeps, never this one. And it just helps to get all this stuff out of the way. Not to mention I'm going to clean it while I have it off because they usually get dirty. Because they'll get pretty smutted up. They don't have much of a area right there. They get all dirty and nasty and stopped up. And yeah, you pretty much just start tearing stuff off until you get down to where you need to be. A set of these little wobble sockets greatly helps this project. Dad over here working on a hound dog cage. Our local hound dog keeps escaping. Is she gonna give it up? All right, there's that part. Always ask me how you learn how to do all this. I did. I just had to if I wanted anything. I never had no money. So we had to make do with what we had. Had to make it run. Okay. Where's that for? Saves that zip tie. I'm sure we'll need it in a minute. If you watch this and you have anything to do with the design of this Jeep, I hate you. You're an idiot. All these stupid little pushy pins and clippy clips. throwing freaking fuel for you. Oh, it might cost you a dollar. Can't be having that. Oh, there it is. See, just like that. You back where you go. In fact, you come off pretty easy. You're gonna come over here and hang out in bolts. You don't go anywhere. So when I need you to go off, put me on. And get yourself as much room as you can everywhere. And you gotta take that oil cooler out of there. It's like a little spike. Got stuff going everywhere. Okay, I think we're ready. Take the intake loose. I think I can leave the ejector's on this time. Got to take them off at Dad's for some reason. I can't remember why now. I did. We've got to figure out how to get this up and out of here without dropping everything in the freaking. See that? That is scary. Let me go get some paper towels. Did any of that go down in there while I was gone? If so, it's just gonna have to. I'm gonna suck all this out of here with a dry vac. You know what, I tried to blow my dad's out before we done all of this, and all it did is, where the stuff had been sitting forever, all it did was make it move, so I thought it would be better off leaving it still and just dealing with it like that. See what we're going after yet? You'll see it down there. Hang on. This guy. Way down in there. That's what we're going after. Sorry, I'm a terrible camera person. I have an even worse personality. Way to get to this. Okay. There's that one. One. Two. And the other one is a hose. It comes off easier once you take it out. Bingo was his name. We'll put these back up before I lose them. Oh yeah, we're making a mess now. Everything is going everywhere. Yeah, the old ones are flat. There we go. There's a new one. that taken care of.
I'm about to try to snake it back in there. Maybe leave the paper towels in place. Horsepower induction. Okay, here we go. Here. Looked down in there, they had a dirt dauber sitting right on top of the valve. I don't know how in the world you'd possibly.
Well, mine wound up with mud in it from somewhere. Our filter was full of mud, maybe something.
I don't know how you'd possibly. That was on the valve, though.
How you get a dirt dauber on the back?
Fell through the intake?
It crawled in there through the intake?
No, I dropped it.
Oh.
Got all the bolts started. One. Here in the back, one started. Alright, let's suck her down tight. Okay. Bring this back where it goes now. Don't know what that's for. Probably insulation. Keep the intake from getting hot. So the motor in this Jeep runs at 3,000 and Satan degrees anyway. Just right. That's just what the doctor ordered. Plug that back in. Run our intake back down for the 14th time. Where this stupid thing is, air handler. I guess it would be a better definition of what it is. Everybody's curious if it's gonna start, huh? I am too. Okay, there's that. Let's cut this down. We can do it.
here. This one goes on our air box. That. If you're still watching, you're pretty dang interested in this. Couple nuts on them. Alright, starting to look like something again. Come from this side. I'm gonna go get the throttle body, put it back on. I can't remember how this goes. Looks just like that. And a breather hose. There she is. Got some breather line, goes right there. Okay, the top end of the motor's back together, except for the intake right here. But I gotta get over there and put those silly bolts, tighten the nuts back up. On the exhaust manifold, hold those two brackets off. They're way down in there. Lord, it looks. I sure beat sitting there with a wrench. Airflow sensor here. Put that on. Forget to put that on, or it'll throw an engine light. This thing don't have enough lights already. That goes out there. Snap it in. You got your old trusty flathead. It's a little big. Tools and we'll start it up and see what happens. Might blow up right here on the spot.
that's the case, we'll just go get another one.
Well, she's running again. Let her run for a minute. I'm going to check the oil and water and take her for a test drive. Pulling out, ran for a while, checked the oil, added a little bit. Temperature seems happy. All that's the anti-lock brake module. It's out. They don't have any of those in the country right now that they want to sell to you anyway. But that don't seem to affect anything. It's just got a bunch of lights on the dash. And the anti-lock brakes don't work, but I don't care about that. Let's see. All right. She's running again. Well, anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.